Hello.
Hi.
You can leave your stuff over there if you want, or in any corner, and if you can follow me.
Do we have to leave our stuff?
No. In case you want to be more comfortable. Hello, everyone. So, if you please, can follow me. Hello. Could you please join the rest of the people over there?
Okay, it's not possible to sit.
For now, so let's old. Say no, you're not old at all. For now. Hello. If you can please follow me. Hello. Can you please follow the group over there?
Okay.
Yeah, let's try to make a big group in the center of the room. But yeah, down the stairs. Yeah, thank you very much. Hello. Could you please join the rest of the people over there? Thank you. And you too? Could you please join the rest of the people over there? Thank you. If you can please step, yep. No, you won't be standing for 1 hour, for sure not. So, welcome everyone. Thanks for coming. This is Social Dissonance and it's a durational concert. We kindly ask you to stay for the whole hour. We will finish at 8 o'clock because it takes some time to build something together, and if you are constantly coming in and out, it's gonna be hard. And I have to let you know in advance that we are being streamed online on Periscope, and the video will be archived and projected tomorrow on this wall over there. So I think we had already a nice suggestion from you two. You started imitating this body over there. So I would like us to start with a short physical exercise and imitate this body.
Thank you. excluded some people and they are spectators. And I didn't like that.
Yes, we should include them.
Yeah, okay.
There's the party.
Go, everybody.
There's the party.
Go.
Running, right? They're still seeing us on the web.
Why not? You like it outside.
Oh. There is a marriage.
Okay. You want to join?
No. But it's an experience that you can have any time.
Maybe it's part of the performance? They close
group,
the door.
Group pressure, not collective thinking.
Look at this one.
Session in, I don't know, body movement, sounds and stuff. So I didn't have a frame of what was actually happening, but I am like familiar to this kind of situation where people are just like doing things and other imitating or not. So. But now it's completely different. If you want, you can just go back to what we did before, start moving again. Or we can also talk, but
yeah,
maybe...
Who is saying what we have to do?
Nobody.
We can find out together, or we can find out on ourselves.
So, we have to invest someone.
We have to do nothing.
We can elect someone.
We can.
To do whatever.
It's beautiful.
Okay, let's have a moment to tell us how we go on.
Maybe we should also find out about which language. So now we use English, but maybe English is not helpful for everybody.
Maybe the body language is helpful for everybody like before.
Why don't you vote between something physical or a conversation?
Because if you start voting, you already start using language.
Should be louder, please.
Yes, okay, thank you. If you start voting, you already opt for something like using language. If we didn't know each other that well, we didn't like know if language is shared. English is not my first language. And I think for many of us, it's not the first language.
So for me, it is. I said for whom? I asked for me this is the first language. We're talking about what language we're going to use.
Okay, now I should pass away.
What language? We're
using English, so everybody can use glossolalia.
What is that?
Well, now is the word past.
What are we
talking about? I don't think it's good.
Bonga.
Okay. Yeah.
There's always something we have in common. components, or we can create some kind of network structure. Mm-hmm. So we can make a network of people with shoes like this, another network of people with black clothes, and some intersect, and then there's other networks like this.
Okay, I see you need a structure.
And then it's actually, it's like a basket, so everything is like moving together. In the whole, it's all together.
It's us. Mm-hmm. We are a basket.
Cases.
I'm not a bug.
According to
sound.
Okay, what we have is we have a time and the energy of several people. Yeah, I'm thinking about if we could spend this energy and time some. In a positive way.
Mm-hmm.
I start thinking about it, and my first idea, maybe we could somehow share our energy or something like that, our appreciation to one person, to give our kind of appreciation and love to one person, to maybe for this person, it would be
nice,
yeah.
Mm. Do you want to choose one?
But I do not know, maybe we could tell one person something nice. just
who wants to?
Let's choose the most sad person.
Sad?
The one that needs our energy the most.
Who is it? Do you
not
think that the world is a tragedy?
I don't think so.
Why?
Look what happens in the world.
Look
at it once, twice, three times. It's always a tragedy. I'm sorry. I can't laugh.
When did you discover that work is a tragedy? Do you remember the
moment? I didn't understand your question.
When
I was born.
No, when you realized that the world is a tragedy.
Well,
when you
understood. Well, it's something that comes slowly. But you realize, you don't agree with me. I'm surprised.
I don't think the world is tragedy. I was always in the world, but how can we swim in the Mediterranean anymore when we know that there are thousands and thousands and thousands of human beings who died, drowned, and nobody came to save them? I'm not saying people didn't individually want to, but our institutions, our government, just let them die. How can we swim we bury people anymore. If you want just one example, maybe the difference is we're so much older than you guys. We're almost 70. And I used to be an optimist. And I still believe in utopia. And the book I read is Ernst Bloch all the time. Nevertheless, every year it seems to get worse and worse.
And I have a completely different opinion. I think the world became better and better. If we would see that, for example, the society of the previous time, we would find that the situation was even worse, you know. All these punishments that were so rude, yeah. And yeah, the relation to others were much more rude. And at current time, we have kind of food. the much more people have the possibility to live, you know. And the situation is better, but it's this is a slow process, you know. It couldn't be fixed in a time of one life.
It needs more people.
No.
Needs more people.
No.
And but we need more people with the right attitude.
Why?
What is
why
the right attitude?
You know, I would say that you have no need special condition to realize that the world is a good place for living. You have the special. You have to need to have special conditions to realize that the world is a bad place. But to be happy, it's kind of very healthy state of body, very healthy state of mind.
And of economic position?
Mm. Yeah, yes,
no,
yes.
I won't say so. I mean, you know, are you poor?
Me?
Yes.
No, no.
Are you happy?
I'm trying to be.
So you are not?
Happiness is for stupid people, I think.
That's right. So, are you stupid?
Are you stupid?
No, I'm happy.
You're just happy, but you're not stupid.
What?
You're contradicting yourself.
Yes.
So,
what's the problem with that?
You're
it's
happy.
Not,
it's
not
but you're
not
stupid.
No, I'm not happy. I said I'm not happy.
Are you not happy?
Yeah.
But why is happy?
Ah,
stupid?
Okay.
You cannot
be
happy.
Happy.
Why?
When
no,
you feel a desire, then you have another one.
No.
But is happiness fulfilling a desire?
No.
Suffering is.
Suffering is?
It's what Buddhism says, that suffering stems from desire.
Yeah.
Suffering is what from desire?
What?
Can you repeat it?
That suffering stems from desire and. Throughout our lifetimes, we are to detach ourselves from desire so that we can.
In order to achieve happiness.
Well, enlightenment. It's
yes.
Not necessarily happiness.
Yes.
But that's one mode of thought.
Yeah, that's one mode.
I think as a species, yes, it is a tragic world. I think as a species, we are evolving, though. I think that technology is bringing us closer together. It's widening our scope of empathy. So,
no. I'm amazed at how many people on buses, in restaurants, in public places, they're with other people, and they spend that time texting or looking on. Is that being with other people?
Yes.
Or sometimes just sit and. Do we always have to be connected? Is that really being with other people?
Yes, I'm with you.
Not in the same place. I'm also with you, but I'm also like thinking why people do it. It also it helps to be connected to people that are not actually in the place. So you can share each moment of performance with people on the internet.
We have no viewers actually now.
Yeah, but actually, previously we spoke about refugees and people in war condition or people poor. They are not. They don't have the privilege of using technology. So,
but the people that do—it's
not. Yeah, but it's not a matter of humanity if it's not for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you can't say this is a part of the species of human evolution if it's not. If it's just for some privileged people.
But it's getting wider. The digital gap is narrowing. So more and more people have access to computers versus 10 years ago, versus 20 years ago. Now there's virtual reality. There's something opening in the lab that is around the refugees so that people can actually be present to that experience through virtual reality. So yes, it's not for everybody just yet, but it is narrowing the gap.
Does it make people happier?
They sometimes
need
to be present in that moment, and that's what I got from what you say. To be present in one moment and help the people in one moment, and not being on the cell phone and sharing with this people and this people and this people, but keeping your eyes open, which people are around you who sometimes needs help.
Agreed. I think that's very very special right now. It's happening because we're all off our phones and we're just connecting. I agree. And sometimes
where
we're
are
so
you going?
Let her go.
We were being connecting.
No, let her go. She wants to. Why not?
She's connected with someone else.
I think the internet is a big echo chamber. You hear voices you want to hear, and you never be able to reach the different voices. And it's more the case with the more advanced technology, the more advanced algorithm to work towards what we want to see and what we want to hear. And that's my take of the internet. That's the problem. We want to see what resonates us, not what doesn't. That is the problem. And not every time, everything, every human have a common place or have a, because we're all different. It's, and we can never ask for an everlasting kind of mutual state. So
I didn't quite get that.
The situation continued for about half an hour, where people were suggesting more and more moves, and everyone was repeating what one or maybe more people were doing. And I think nobody really questioned what we were doing at the time and why we are doing it, why we are following someone else's moves. We entered inside the space and we just started replicating something without knowing if it meant something. Mm-hmm. And then most people had the opportunity to leave the space. And
they left.
Yes, and then the whole conversation made me think that people thought that this experience was connecting somehow. I mean, maybe most of you already know each other somehow, but this whole conversation about how technology is connecting us all, and I found it very alienating in a way.
Mm-hmm. Like driving us
the way we
away
were
from each other.
We were replicating these moves and without thinking at all, just moving inside the space according to what other people were doing, and then saying how we can be connecting on Facebook. Like there is a big discrepancy of what we perceive as connection and what we do in everyday life.
Yeah.
I agree too. I think it's rare that you take a moment to like look people in the eye and really see your soul. I don't know anybody here, but I feel like I know a little bit more of your soul because it just shines through you. And specifically, because I see you like grabbing your heart, I see you feeling, you know, like we met just, you know, not too long ago.
The most interesting thing about what happened in the start to me, except from what Ellen said about following one another without thinking, was the fact that some of us, the younger ones, were moving really
without taking into account that some other people could not follow. And the other people were excluded so roughly. And then after that, we did the whole conversation about another exclusion. I mean, I think we and in the conversation and in the first place, in the imitation of the movement, we did not question our privileged position. In the first, our young and, you know, a strong body that could do everything, and in the second, our being European, our being, you know, having like several privileges, more than, you know, like 70% of the planet.
But, you know, can
so
I,
to
I
me,
can I interrupt?
She's on a phone.
Yeah. To me, it was very, very strong, these two things that happened in the first place and in the second one.
Was it the first time that people went out? Didn't imitate the movement? Today, no, huh?
But we're not doing this.
Okay. So every evening you have another... Okay.
I think it would have been very visible,
the fact that we cannot all do the same things. When I did the move, you know, like there, I thought this could be... understood as something that no one, not all of the people could follow, so this is why I did it. But still, it didn't brought any attention, like they continued doing stuff together. Then the old people were discovered in the corner of the room, and they were excluded, of course they were excluded. Then is the question about who is more capable of talking in public and who feels less possibility less open to speak in public, and I can see some people here that they haven't spoke at all, and this is why I suggested the computer as a main medium of talking.
Means of communication.
Yeah, it would have been one. And also for the conversation about the technology, I think technology is great, it's giving us great opportunities, but the question is for me to how to rearrange our work conditions throughout technology, not just talk to someone who's in Australia and just don't call him, because we had phones also before.
This is
one
still
second,
excluding
one second,
some
please.
People.
This is, I think, a different topic. Again, I found it interesting what she was saying, like, about the exclusion, inclusion, and thinking about people. I mean, I myself asked, we didn't, you know, impose on people, or none of us did. We didn't force anyone to do what we did, you know, what each one of us was doing. So if I do like this, I don't tell you to imitate me. You can, but you can also do, and then everyone can decide if he is actually following you, if he's following me, if he's doing or she is doing her own thing. And actually they, you know, if you talk about older people not being so powerful with their body or not being so capable of doing such movements, you know, they actually had this right, of course, but they actually had huge power over us too. You know, they stopped us from doing what we're doing here. We were having this circle, and they were sitting there, you know, just by being there, just by doing nothing or apparently nothing, they stopped us from doing what we were doing. So actually, it's not about only moving your body or being capable of jumping around.
It's
or,
always the same.
You know,
now it's the same situation like before. Do you realize that?
Like what?
Do you realize that this is exactly the same situation like before with the band?
because maybe we could listen to them.
With the what?
With the body movement, and we were moving and doing stuff what not everybody could do, or something like that. And
no, it has not to do with what can do, but if you want to do it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I think the question is, if you want to participate in the group or not. Mm-hmm. If you want to see things from outside, mm-hmm. and to observe from a faraway distance, or if you want to be in the group, it has, it's not an, it's a self-exclusion somehow.
But the decision, yeah?
Yeah.
And I think, I don't know who maybe it's a good, someone said, you are excluded.
Yeah.
But that is your feeling. Maybe the person who is outside doesn't have the feeling to be excluded.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's your decision to say your impression, your... I think if you are, you can be out of a circle,
mm-hmm.
but you are not excluded.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
But you could be within with the energy, or how the, or with the intention.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But then by saying you